the South African Institute of Professional Accountants, making meaningful contributions to the accountancy profession and your career.
Hi, I'm Bonzo Madikizela, a senior lecturer in accounting at the University of Johannesburg. Joining a professional body like SAIPA suggests that one is conscious about who they are, their choice of working environment, and the experiences they want to have. I encourage my students to obtain the SAIPA Professional Accountant SA designation.
Professional Accountant SA, the accounting designation of choice.
The accounting designation of choice, and that's the South African Institute of Professional Accountants. Joining us this evening is the executive for technical and standards. Yes, Mam Faith Ngwenya. Tonight we're talking about the tax season 2018 for individuals. The South African Revenue Services has announced that they will be shortening this period or this tax season for non-provisional taxpayers by 1 month. And we are talking to Mam Faith just to understand exactly why the Revenue Services has done that, as well as other things that we'll speak to in the course of the conversation. So Mam Faith, thank you so much for joining us this evening, and welcome to Africa Business Radio.
Thank you, Nqobani. Good evening to the listeners as well.
All right, Mam Faith, this is unprecedented in as far as I know, at least from the time that I started following and being an accountant myself, that the Revenue Services has done this. Why do you think the Revenue Services has done this, Ma?
The reason that they actually are doing this is it really is for the benefit of SARS to finalize their processes before the silly season. So the aim is that the filing season closes early so that they can respond back to the practitioners and the taxpayers well before December. If one is listening to what they really are planning for the next year, so this year they have just shortened the end date by 1 month. Mm-hmm. But what they are planning to do, hopefully from next year, is to actually bring the entire filing season to an earlier start. So rather than opening it on the 1st of July, that they open it, probably it will be a month earlier, and then obviously be able to close it a month earlier as well compared to the November. Because what they have found is that by the time people get the assessments or where they are calls for a substantiation of the amounts that have been claimed, mm-hmm. those come through during or immediately before the holiday season.
Mm.
And hence, it doesn't give the taxpayers sufficient time to respond, because remember, there are very strict deadlines. One is 30 days, 60 days. So once you miss that, you obviously have missed it, and you are not going to be able to get the benefit of the whatever objection, if it's an objection. But that really is the reason why they are bringing it forward.
On those grounds, I think it really sounds quite reasonable, and it sounds quite fair, I mean, for them to do that. It's just that the thing that is worrying is that it's now going to be 4 months, and we have not seen that. But also, what sounds positive is that next year they'll move it back a month. But I've spoken to quite a few people, and they have been thinking that one of the main reasons is that the receiver, in as much the revenue authority, in as much as they want to move it back by a month, they're also trying to ensure that all the PAYEs for those who had underpaid, the money comes in even much earlier because of an assumed cash pressure that the country is going under. What would you say to that?
That might be partly the reason, although they have not really cited that as the reason. But obviously, by early assessment means early payment of whatever amounts that are outstanding. But just bear in mind that the PAYE submission dates are still going to be May and August. So the reconciliation dates are not going to be changed. So it's just a matter of making sure that by the time that the filing is done, it gives them enough time and for payment as well. I mean, that's true. That they really want to collect as much as possible before they get to the end of the financial year. So one can't run away from that.
Mm.
But one of the reasons is the early cash flow that's going to result out of an early closure to the filing season.
All right. And as the institution, what plans have you put in place to help your members, should any of them maybe struggle? I don't see if there's a reason that they should, but is there anything that you have put in place in particular for this tax, for the individual tax, non-provisional taxpayers closing season earlier?
Okay. What we obviously did, we initiate, the first thing that we have to do was to try and negotiate with the revenue services that they do not implement immediately, because I think they announced this in April.
Yes, April.
And yeah, so for them to obviously be implementing it like 2 months before the start of the filing season, we were not happy with it.
Mm.
But then they obviously said, well, their processes are already there and they will be ready for the early closure. So what we then had to do is, because we obviously couldn't change the decision,
mm-hmm.
it was then to start the awareness with our members. So we have in various fora advised members that they shouldn't really procrastinate, because you know that South Africa has a tendency of waiting until the last few days before closure. So in this case, one might be thinking that I have planned for my filing to be done in, for example, the first 2-3 weeks in November.
Mm.
So now to know that you do not have those 3 weeks that you always had in November, we have to warn them that do everything before then, because it is being cut by the month earlier. So it's now going to be closing at the end of October. So that's the only thing that one could actually do, is just to create that awareness. We will continue with this awareness even as we approach the start of the filing season.
All right, Mom Faith, I think that's the most that we can do, and obviously this platform is one of those that is going to assist in spreading that word across the board for all taxpayers as well as practitioners alike. But thank you so much this evening for borrowing us your time so that we can at least spread this word even more than we have done. And I think even closer to the time, maybe before the end of October, maybe end of September, we'll again have this conversation to resensitize practitioners as well as non-provisional taxpayers about this, so they can be able to comply.
Yes, thanks.
All right, thank you. That was Mom Faith Ngwenya of the South African Institute of Professional Accountants, the executive for technical and standards, just giving us her perspective on the shortening of the tax season for non-provisional taxpayers, yes, by a month, following an announcement that was made by the South African Revenue Services. And the logic that they share is that it will allow them enough time to finalize verification and audits before silly season, and that's year end, because we know that you only have 1 month to be able to object and for any audits to be done should you want to go and have your file or assessment reopened.